Hi, my name is Ann Cassesso Ercolini, and I work at the Somerville Public Library. I'm sure a lot of you know me. And one of my favorite things to do is to tell stories. And I tell stories for SCATV on Channel 3, so you can check it out there or you can check it out online. I'd love you to watch some stories or come to the library and listen to some stories here in the library live. Okay, so you don't want a unicorn. Do you think you do?
No.
Okay, I don't think you do either. Wait. You were going to wish for a unicorn, weren't you?
No.
Wishing for a unicorn is a big, big mistake. Just step away and blip. Uh-oh. Things are about to get... ugly. Things are going to get ugly. Trust me. Because there it is. Somebody wished for the unicorn.
Not
one of you?
No.
Did you guys wish? No?
No.
Sure. No. Having a unicorn seems like fun, right? And at first it is. All right. It's super fun. It's really super fun. Fine. It's awesome, okay? It's awesome to have a unicorn. But it's not worth it. What you don't know is unicorns shed and they scratch. And no matter how hard you try, these pages don't want to turn. Unicorns can't be house trained. That's not good.
What is that?
What? This? Cupcakes.
No.
Well, you don't want that. Trust me. Don't even get me started on the jumping. Look what happens when a unicorn jumps. They put a hole in the ceiling. The chewing. And the burping. Hey, not bad. You probably could pull this off. Look what happened. Cupcakes. If it wasn't for the biggest, top secret, nobody knows about it problem with having a unicorn. Unicorns live in groups. And when a unicorn gets lonely, ding, ding, ding. Oh no, it calls a friend. Poof! No! Right when you're thinking this could be double super fun?
Double?
Double super fun. Poof! There's another. Poof! And another. Poof! And another! Oh no, great! You've unleashed the most destructive force in the universe. Do you know what that is? A unicorn party! Look at that party. Does it look like fun?
Yeah.
It does?
They're ruining
everything. Look at the walls and the floor. They're making a big mess, those unicorns. I told you. Why didn't you trust me? Quick, grab your piggy bank. Run, you have to wish them away. Let's see if we can close our eyes and wish them away. Ooh. Are you wishing? Blip, 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 blip. Poof, 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 poof. Woo. I think you did it. Yeah. This one needs to go back too. One more wish. Blip. And one, look, one more. Blip. Who did that blip? Did one of you do that wish?
No.
That blip?
No.
Poof. Ah, cheer up. You could get a goldfish or a nice rock or, look what's there. What is it? Uh-oh. What is it? A dinosaur. So that's what you could wish for. What did you think of that story?
Yeah.
Did you like it? Thumbs up? Thumbs down?
Thumbs down!
Wow! I thought you were wishing for unicorns.
No, they're too messy.
But you got to, you got, you, they're too messy?
I wish for
them.
I
wouldn't you
like
did.
Unicorns in my house.
Uh-oh. Somebody wished for a dinosaur. Who wished for the dinosaur?
Me.
All right. Okay. You wish for a fish? I would wish for a koala bear. Okay. All right. Story number, is this story number 10? 2. Okay, and this is called Peace at Last. You're laughing already. Okay, what is that?
A cat.
A cat looking at the moon. Okay, so peace at last. The hour was late. See how late it is? It's very dark, right? It's nighttime. Mr. Bear was tired. Mrs. Bear was tired, and Baby Bear was tired, so they all went to bed. Mrs. Bear fell asleep. Mr. Bear didn't. See him wide awake? Okay. Mrs. Bear began to snore. Went Mrs. Bear. Oh, no, said Mr. Bear. I can't stand this. So he got up and he went to sleep in Baby Bear's room. Baby Bear was not sleeping either. He was laying in bed pretending to be an airplane. Meow, meow, meow. Oh, no, said Mr. Bear. I can't stand this. So he got up again and went to sleep in the living room. Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock went the living room clock. Cuckoo, 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 cuckoo. Oh, no, I can't stand this. So off he went to sleep in the kitchen. Drip. Drip, drip, drip went the kitchen faucet. Went the refrigerator. Oh, no, I can't stand this. So he got up and he went to sleep in the garden. In the garden? Well, you would not believe what noises there are in the garden at night. Hoo, 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 went the owl. Went the hedgehog. Meow, meow, sang the cats on the wall. Oh, no, I can't stand this. So off Mr. Bear went to sleep in the, where do you think you could sleep now? The car. It was cold in the car and uncomfortable. But Mr. Bear was so tired, he didn't even notice. He was just falling asleep when all the birds started to chirp and the sun peeped in at the window. Tweet, 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 tweet. Shine, shine went the sun. Oh, no. I can't stand this. So he got up. And he went back into the house. In the house, Baby Bear was fast asleep. And Mrs. Bear had turned over, and she wasn't snoring anymore. Mr. Bear got into bed, and he closed his eyes. Ah, peace at last, he said to himself. Went the alarm clock. Brrr. Mrs. Bear sat up. Oh, and she rubbed her eyes. Good morning, dear, she said. Did you sleep well? Did he? Not very well, dear, yawned Mr. Bear. Never mind, said Mrs. Bear. I'll bring you the mail and a nice cup of tea. And she did. And that's the end. What did you think? Did you like that one? Mr. Bear didn't get any sleep, did he?
No,
everybody, what was Baby Bear doing pretending to be a plane? What kind of noise did he make? Meow, meow, meow. Okay. All right, that is story number 100.
Two.
Okay. Now we have... I think we'll do this one, Lizard's Home. Lizard is one of my favorite little characters. I love him. See how cute he is? He's purple. He's green, right. All right, so this is called Lizard's Home. Remember Lizard when we sang Zoli, Zoli, Zoli? All right, so this is Lizard's Home. Lizard sang as he walked toward home after playing all day with Toad. Zoli, 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 Zoli. Rock is my home, rock is my home, Zoli, Zoli, Zoli. A few more feet and he'd curl up snug on his rock to go to sleep. But when Lizard got home, Snake was sound asleep on his rock. I don't know why. Hello? Hello? I'm afraid you've made a mistake. Everybody knows that rock is my home. Said Snake. I don't make mistakes. I found it. I'll keep it. It suits me just fine. Lizard ran to ask Toad for help. Not me, Toad gulped. She could swallow us whole. That night, Lizard sat at a distance, watching Snake snore. It had been Lizard's rock since the day he had hatched. Now we didn't have a place to go. And as the locust chirped, Lizard sang a wish song to help him fall asleep. Twinkle little, blink a little, high up in the sky a little, rock a little, hope a little, hope and Snake will go. Do you think that song will work?
No.
When Lizard woke the next morning, Snake was gone. Lizard ran to tell Toad that his wish had come true. But when he got home, Snake was sitting on his rock again. Lizard took a deep breath. Perhaps, he said, you've mistaken my rock for another one. Everybody knows this rock is my home. Said Snake, I don't make mistakes. I found it. I'll keep it. It suits me just fine.
Again?
Yep, again. Snake hissed, and Lizard ran to hide among the pebbles and the burrs. As the stars came out, Snake began to snore. But Lizard was determined not to fall asleep. He'd reclaim his rock as soon as Snake left to eat. To help stay awake, he sang his wish song very fast. Twinkle a little, blink a little, high up in the sky a little, rock a little, hope a little, hope and Snake will go. He sang faster, then slower. Then he sang and he danced. By the middle of the night, he was snoring too. Lizard woke at dawn and slowly opened one eye. Snake was gone. In a leap, Lizard was home on his rock and grinning as he went back to sleep. So he got his rock. He was still fast asleep when the sun went down. "Sss," said Snake, "get off my rock." Lizard jumped awake. He knew just singing a wish wouldn't work this time. He took a deep breath and he said, "I found it. I keep it. Everybody knows it suits me fine." "I found it," said Snake. "I found it. And everyone knows I don't make mistakes. I don't." "Please be fair," Lizard begged. "At least give me one chance." "No," Lizard shook his head. "But everybody knows that not being fair is a big mistake." "I never make mistakes," said Snake. "All right, you get one chance." "Great," said Lizard. "All right, we'll get a sack with two pebbles, one white pebble and one black pebble. If I grab the black, I get to stay. If I grab the white, you get to stay. And I'll never say you made a mistake again." "Okay," said Snake with a shifty grin. "But I get to choose the pebbles, and I get to choose the sack." "Fair enough," said Lizard. "I'll invite everyone and meet you by the river when the sun comes up." All his friends were at the river when Lizard arrived. "Run," said Toad, "you've got to hide." Rabbit heard Snake brag that both pebbles she put in the sack are white. "So there's two white pebbles in the sack. You'll lose no matter which one you choose." "Don't worry," said Lizard. "Everybody knows Snake never makes mistakes." He quietly sang as Toad shook his head. "Twinkle little, blink a little, high up in the sky a little, rock a little, hope a little." "Quiet," said Snake. "Just close your eyes and reach into that sack. Black, you stay just like you said. White, I stay." What's going to happen? I don't. Lizard slowly put his foot in the sack. He felt both pebbles, took one out, and yanked it. But before anyone could see if it was black or if it was white, the pebble slipped loose and sank into the river with a splash. Snake laughed. "Ha, ha, ha, ha. There's no way to prove what pebble you grabbed. You lost your chance." "No, I didn't," said Lizard. "There's still one pebble in the sack. And if it's black, then mine was the white one, and you get the rock. If it's white, then mine was black, and I get the rock." Snake stammered, but you can't be sure." "Of course we can," said Lizard. "Everybody knows you don't make mistakes. I'm sure you fixed the sack and the pebbles just right." Snake slowly turned the sack upside down. Guess what fell out?
White.
A white pebble. "Proof," yelled Toad. "Lizard's had to be the black." "Proof," Lizard grinned. "Rock is my home." Everyone cheered. Lizard felt so good, he couldn't help but sing all the way back home. "Twinkle little, blink a little, high up in the sky a little. Zoli, 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 rock is my home, rock is my home. Zoli, zoli, zoli." And Lizard got his rock back. Did you like that one?
Yeah.
That's one of my favorites. I love Lizard's stories. I like him a lot. You like the snake?
I like the
dog. Oh.
I like the green.
Okay.
I like the red one.
You like the red?
I like the snake.
You like the snake too?
I like the red one.
All right. So what story was that? Story number 200? Story number. You did? Okay. All right. We still have two more stories. One is called Bear With Me. See the bear? Okay. Here we go. Bear with me. It started off just right. I had a mom and a dad and my own set of blocks. I had everything I needed. Then, one day, my mom and my dad brought home a surprise. I don't like surprises. Surprises are never as good as you have hoped for. They said they always wanted a bear. They said now our family was complete. I thought the family already was complete. The bear's name was Gary. What do you think? Do you like Gary as your part of your family? I told my mom and dad that they should have asked me if I wanted a bear. If they had asked, they would have known that I don't want a bear. They said Gary was going to sleep in my room. They said Gary gets to use all my toys. I said, I don't like sharing. What if he breaks my stuff? They said, that's the way it is now. Later, I asked my mom to take me to the park to fly my kite. She said, not right now, because she had to take Gary for a walk. I asked my dad to build a block castle with me, but he said, not right now, because he had to put together Gary's new bed before bedtime. He didn't even ask me to help. Gary's snores are so loud that it sounds like there's a helicopter flying around in circles in my room. He snores like that. Gary forgets to put the caps back on my markers. Gary broke the swing in the backyard. That Gary. I said, that stinks, Gary, to nobody. He looks very sad, doesn't he? He's sitting all by himself. And now Gary is sitting with them. But Gary looks kind of sad too, doesn't he? And then Gary goes inside. And it turns out that Gary is really, really good with blocks. He's really good at building. You see what he got? See what he did? Pretty good, right? He knows how to make things fit just right.
Look, he's making a big
yeah. Gary even showed me how we could still use the swing. Look, how is he using it? Bear is holding it up for him, right? And I showed him how to care for our markers. Maybe surprises are not so bad. Some surprises turn out to even be better than you had hoped for. Look at Gary. What's he doing? He's snoring.
And that little boy has headphones on.
So he doesn't hear him, right? I think he still makes a lot of noise. But look, he gets to fly his kite with Gary. So it looks like he's having fun with Gary after all. And that's the end. Did you like Gary? Maybe one day your mom and dad will bring a Gary home to you.
No. That would crush my house.
That would crush your house?
Yeah.
Probably.
It would crush mine.
Would crush yours too?
Mine.
Everybody's.
Not mine.
Yeah, we can't fit a bear in our house.
My house.
No? Okay.
A small bear.
Okay. A little bear? Oh, if we could get a little one that big, would you want one? Yeah. Did we have fun?
Yeah.
Well, I'm so happy that you came. And we'll do it again. Okay? Do you want to say goodbye to everybody on TV so they can see you? Turn around.
Goodbye.
Turn around and... Yeah, everybody. But we want to sing Pearly Shells first, right?
Yes.
All right, do the hand motions because you guys do it the best. Pearly shells, pearly shells, from the ocean, shining in the sun, shining in the sun. Covering the shore, when I see them, my heart tells me that I love you more than all those little pearly shells.